Hi everyone, welcome back to video number 7 of making the most of your Mac video series. For this video, we're going to be talking about the bootable USB flash drive that holds macOS. This version will be using Big Sur for this example, and you'll need a USB flash drive that is at least able to hold 14 gigabytes of data. I recommend a 16 gigabyte flash drive at the least. I use a 32 gigabyte in this example. However, as long as it can hold one 14 gigabyte file, essentially, it'll be enough to handle what we're going to do here. We'll be using terminal. We'll be using the create install media command through terminal to create a flash drive that you can plug into a Mac with zero operating system. You might have the flashing folder, and from there, by holding option, you'll be able to call up the flash drive and enter recovery or macOS utilities through the flash drive and install macOS from the flash drive rather than using an internet connection to download it. So the first step is get a USB flash drive that is at least 16 gigabytes. In my suggestion, 32 would be best. Plug it into the USB port on your device and open up Spotlight Search. Type in Disk Utility. From there, 32 gigabyte USB flash drive in this example here. And from there, you'll want to click on Show All Devices. When you do that, you'll be able to see that the 32 gigabyte flash drive is indeed an external device. Click erase and name it, for this example, all lowercase macOS. That's what I choose because it's easy to remember, and you'll see in a moment where it comes in on the command line. Pick macOS extended journaled as the formatting option for your flash drive and choose erase. When completed, you'll get a green check mark noting that the device is ready. It's formatted, macOS extended journaled, and it's ready to be used in the next step. So click on done, and step 2 will be to download, for this example, macOS Big Sur from the App Store. Now, this little alert here says install macOS Big Sur. This happens after you download macOS from the App Store if you're running an operating system that is of a newer version, say Monterey. So for this example, I was running Monterey. I downloaded Big Sur from the App Store. This alert came up when the automatic install tried to start to install Big Sur on a machine that was already running Monterey. So it gives you the code HT201372. That's the article that we are going to use to get the command line that we're going to enter into terminal in the next few steps. So you can just quit this here. As long as the install file that you download on the App Store shows up in your applications folder, you can go to Go in the Apple icon menu bar, and then Applications. Make sure the install macOS Big Sur or whatever version you have shows up in that folder, and you're ready to go to the next step. Open up terminal, and you're going to need to use this command that comes from the support article HT201372. Go to the section that says create install media command in terminal. From there, copy and paste the whole command that you see in a notes file. For this example, we choose macOS Big Sur. You're going to make sure that you get the whole string, because on the website it only shows you about half of it. You have to put your cursor inside the text box when you're copying pasting and make sure you drag it all the way to the end until you get to the end where it says My Volume. And that's where, in this case, we are going to have all lowercase macOS, because that's the name of our volume. So once you have that copied and you have the correct version of macOS downloaded and in your applications folder. Again, for us, this will be Big Sur for this example. You can open up Terminal and enter the command exactly how it is shown, but at the very end of the command, you'll type in macOS or whatever you decided to name your flash drive as. In this case, it's macOS, all lowercase. So let's have a look. All right, so we'll go through that in a few steps. Just to start out, the important thing is that you enter the command line exactly as shown. The first thing Terminal will ask is for you to enter your password. Now, Terminal will not show you the password as you enter it, but it is being entered behind the scenes. So when you know you've entered your password, hit enter, and it will start the next steps. It'll ask you, do you want to erase the disk? That's talking about the USB flash drive that you've named macOS. It's going to erase it and then rename it. That's why it's important that you know what you named it. In this case, macOS is what we named it. So let's watch it one more time. You'll not see your account password as you type it. Just press enter and then type uppercase Y. The copying disk process, although it shows it very quickly here, it takes about 40 minutes to reach 100%. But then in the end, you will see install macOS Big Sur when you look for it in Finder. That ends this video. We'll make another video just to show you what to do once you've reached that step. So thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.